I brought something which will help me to explain certain things in a shorter time. So I'll start with the demo. The topic is COVID in 2021, how to deal with it. To deal with the COVID, you just have to ask yourself only one question. And what is that question? If you see this banana, you will know the question. You have to find the answer. I could not find in last 1 year, although I have seen more than 50,000 patients so-called suffering from COVID-19. So whatever you have heard till now about COVID-19 from the mainstream media or whoever, with keeping your mind open, try to understand it once again. Today, on 26th of January, Republic Day, right, just think about 1 year back. 1 year back, at the same time, it was just in the newspaper, just something is happening in Wuhan. We were not concerned and worried about it. Just like a movie, we were seeing some clips in the television. So that's what was seen, right? So that was the first introduction. It's like a trailer of a new blockbuster movie which comes. Before the movie comes, a teaser comes. So that was a teaser which you were seeing on the screen. That was your television screen or newspaper, right? So that's how it started. So now, have an impression once again. So this, to make you understand what is COVID, assuming that you have a complete open mind. Now, this is a banana, and I have something to cut. Thank you. So I'm cutting the banana, and you are not able to see on the because it is down. I don't want to see, want you to see while I'm cutting the banana. Now I could cut it in pieces, and I will show the pieces to you. So on the screen, I am sure that you are able to see the pieces. So now, and I have used any one of these this to cut it. So can you tell me out of this, which one I have used to cut this banana? Can you say, tell me, right? These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which one has cut this banana? You cannot tell me because all of them look same, and whichever I use, it will cut in the same fashion. Nobody in the world can say which of this stick I have used to cut the banana. Only Dr. Khadar Wali or Dr. Vijay Kumar can say, because they were just sitting right here, and while I was cutting it, they were watching it. So that is, they can see it, but you cannot see, you cannot tell because you could not see it. So now, like this, when infection happens, in the upper respiratory tract, right? So that is called upper respiratory tract infection, which is called influenza-like illness, which is called flu. When you cough, when you cold, then what happens? Like these stick, one of the stick is responsible for cutting inside your upper respiratory tract, causing infection. And those which are there inside, they can be rhinovirus, they can be coronavirus, they can be adenovirus, they can be influenza virus, they can be H1N1. All of them causes infection exactly in the same way. In the same way, like all the stick will cut the banana exactly in the same way. Right? If you have not seen which one I used, you cannot tell, nobody can tell in the world. So now, a patient with cough and cold, he present to the doctor, and doctor suspect that he is a COVID patient, so he goes for a test. And in the test, he says it is COVID positive. This means SARS-CoV-2 virus is there in the respiratory tract. The virus is there in the respiratory tract, but how we are sure that this virus is responsible to cut the and make the infection, right? The test only say, even if the test is 100% perfect, that this virus is there in the respiratory tract. But did we test for other viruses also, which are the normal resident of your respiratory tract? Normally, at this time also, while I'm speaking to you, there is a great chances that COVID virus may be staying here, right? Adenovirus also simultaneously staying here. Influenza virus is also here because that is their residence, right? And they stay here. Sometimes some of them become naughty, and that causes cough and cold, that causes flu, but then our immune system are super guard, they are security people, they take care of it, right? So by testing, one can only say, yes, this virus is present. Present, but at that moment, did we test for H1N1? Did we test for influenza virus? Did we test for adenovirus? No, that test we have stopped. We did not. Had we had those tests, they would have been also come positive. So only testing can say that this virus is the witness there, right? Even if it is there, it is a witness. But this has caused that problem. There is no proof. If there is some proof, I invite any of you, bring the proof that this virus has caused the pneumonia and rest of the virus did not. There is no proof at all. So it is saying that COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2 is a new virus, right? On 4th of January 2020, it is said a new virus has come in the world, but they did not give any proof. They did not give any proof. If you have any proof, anybody, right? So show me the proof. There is no proof, right? So with modern medicine is called evidence-based. If it is evidence-based, then where is the evidence? There is no evidence. If there is evidence, so it, where is it? Right? Somebody coming on the screen saying one thing 10 times, 20 times, 30 times, 100 times, right? Louder and louder does not mean that the thing will become truth automatically. Thing will become truth only when we show some evidence. And I can tell you, right, there is no evidence as of now that this is a, thank you, sir. Thank you. This is a new virus. So to start with that we are having a new virus in the world. Somebody is saying, who is that person? That is not a God. It is one man, one human organization, say WHO, one day announced there is a new virus coming. But they should have given some supporting evidence, right? Unfortunately, there is no evidence for it, right? There is no evidence to prove it is a new virus. This virus might have been there since last several years, right? But now they might have devised some method to detect it, right? For example, like your own society where you stay, right? Your residence where you stay, the society. There are several dogs which also stay. It is a residence for those dogs as well, right? But you never pay attention how many dogs are there, what are the color of the dog. Maybe sometime you know there is one black dog to four or five brown colored dog. You have a rough idea, right? But someday when you carefully decide that I will check that how many and what color dog, what size dog are there in my colony, then you may discover, oh, there is a white dog also. But that is a discovery. That does not mean that dog is born that day only, right? So saying that a new virus is there, so without giving any proof, right, this means if the virus may not be new. That is the one thing. Now the two more things. People say if it was existing before also, then why so many people are coming COVID positive now? Because now so many tests are being conducted, right? In India, about 10 crore tests has done, and the false positive rate of this COVID-19 RT-PCR test is about 10%. For example, now say there are 100 people in this hall and all of them are tested for COVID, on average 10 people will come COVID positive, right? And you test again after some time, maybe at that time only 5 minutes, again 10 different people will come positive, and those who came positive, they will come negative. So this is a test which is not approved by anybody. Now you may think, you may say, how can I say all this without proof? I don't want to say anything without proof. So whatever I'm saying, all I have collected and put in this book. And this book you can download freely by going to biswaroop.com/nice book, B-O-O-K book. So when you go there, you will get the book. And when you go in the book, in the first chapter, this book and this book, two books, if you go, this is biswaroop.com/COVID-1981. You will get the evidence that this test is not approved by anybody. In fact, FDA US has said that we have not approved, and we cannot guarantee whether this test works or not. The manufacturer of the test or the inventor of the test, Kerry Mullis, nobody has said that this test is for COVID-19 or it can detect any virus for that matter. So it is as good as a dice which you play in a Ludo, right? You can imagine that when it comes 6, right? I can believe that he's a COVID positive. It is as accurate as that. So why so many COVID patients? They are not saying that so many COVID patients. They're saying cases. Cases are not patient. The first important rule, cases are not patient. you want to increase number of patient, if I want to prove that there are 1 lakh cases, I have to do 10 lakh test. If you want to prove there is no cases, you don't do any test. So the first truth of COVID-19 is there, it is always in the headline, right, that today there are 1 lakh new cases. So that means into 10, today they have done 10 lakh tests. So someday, if you can tell me how many COVID cases, I can predict how many tests they have done. So that is a simple ratio. Any day the government want to prove there are say 2 lakh COVID cases discovered today, this means today they might have done about 20 lakh tests. So that is the truth of why so many cases. They are all healthy people. They are made to believe that you are sick, because in the machine, in the RT-PCR test, it is coming out to be positive. But fortunately for me, when my people, my patient, they are healthy people, but I'm calling them patient because that is how they believe. They come to me and they say, I am tested positive. What should I do? I say that you have to spend some money. You go for test 10 times and it will come negative, right? Maybe about 4 times come negative. You can choose that and show to your company, wherever you belong to. And then you start your working. Don't need not to worry. And this method has worked many, many times, all the time. And I've given all the evidence in the book, right? We have kept all the records. So whenever a patient comes to me without any symptom, but they are tested positive, my solution is you go for the test again, 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 right? And they come out to be negative, and they're happily negative, right? If that negative make you happy, then you go for the test, right? So that is one thing. Now, the last thing is, why so many death? In India, we say about 1.5 lakh people died. Right, in the world about 2 million people, 20 million people died. So why so many deaths? So the answer is, every year, because of influenza, because of flu, every year about 5 lakh to 6 lakh people die. Right, so all the data I'm giving you, the reference is there in the book, right? And this reference is not my reference, it is already standard WHO, CDC, FDA, yeah, Government of India, ICMR. So from there we have taken something which is acceptable to the world. So every year 5 lakh to 6.5 lakh people die, that is very common for last 10 year average, of flu, of influenza like illness. This year, how many people died of influenza-like illness, ILI? How many people died of flu? If you go to the data of US, if you go to the data UK, you'll be shocked or surprised to see this year, zero people died of flu. Zero people died of influenza-like illness. Why? Because those people are given a new name, COVID-19 death, instead of flu death. And these things are with proof, again in the book, right? So now coming to India, why so many people died? Why so large number of death? But when you say that you are a tall man, this means in your mind there is a picture of a shorter man. When you say you are a fat, this means there is a picture of a thin man. So when you say more death, this means previous year there has been lesser death because of this particular category of illness, and the category is influenza-like illness. Can you tell me how many people died in 2019 of influenza-like illness in India? Can you tell me that? You cannot, because here till 2019, government did not keep any data of how many people die of influenza-like illness. So when you do not have a data of the previous year, how you know these many deaths are more death or these are the deaths which happens every year? You cannot say, only with comparison. If I say I'm a rich man, this means in my mind there is a comparison with somebody else, or my how much I earned the previous year in comparison to this year, right? This year I became richer. I can tell only when I know how much I earned the previous year. So I again challenge you that you try to ask someone, if you are influential, can you find a data how many people died of influenza-like illness in 2019 in India, or any year for that matter? I can tell you, only for 1 year, it was 2017, because of pneumonia in Lancet, it was published. Again, the references are there. About 1.5 million people died of pneumonia in one particular year. And this year, how many people died of COVID-19? 1.5 lakh, right? So maybe the people who died of pneumonia, right, they got a name of COVID-19. This year, how many people died of pneumonia? Zero people died of pneumonia. So it is a good trick. The people who anyway die of pneumonia every year, say about 1.5 lakh in India, this year when they died, they given a new name, COVID-19, instead of calling them a pneumonia death. Oh, you don't believe me? Then again, I will refer to this book. Go to ICMR, you can Google it, or you can go to the reference. You write in the Google ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research, and you write how to report COVID-19 death. How to report COVID-19 death. And then in Government of India website will open, and in that website there will be one page. That page specifically I will show you, very, very interesting page. It will open your eyes, and yeah, I don't know whether you can see it. It is page number 18 when you get this book, right? So a table will come. This table is directly from ICMR website, and this table says that when a person will die in India of any cause, die of electric shock, die of jumping from 10th floor of the building, die of accident, die of bullets, you have to do COVID test. And if it comes COVID positive, then the cause of death is COVID positive. COVID, not anything else. If a person die of fourth stage cancer, but he comes COVID positive, write COVID positive as a cause, not the cancer. No, it is not what I am saying, it is the what ICMR guideline is saying. So if the person comes COVID negative, then also you write COVID death if at the time of dying he had a symptom of COVID. I have seen 50,000 patients, of flu patient, you can call it, influenza patient call it, or you can call COVID patient, whatever name you can give, in last few months, right? 50,000 patients. And I can tell you, for COVID-19, there is no special symptoms, right? Body ache, fever, cough and cold, headache, all are COVID symptoms, which are a normal symptom for any flu. Even no symptom is also a symptom, asymptomatic. So there is no special symptom. If at the time of dying, if somebody is having a breathing problem, oh, it is a COVID death. But anybody who will die, they must be having breathing problem. After all, breathing stops at the time of dying. So now you understand what is happening. And this means, to conclude here, wearing a mask or PPE kit, looking like a joker, these are things to scare the people. Who is doing it, how it is doing it, that's something else. It is written in the book. I will not talk about it. You can go through it, right? And finally, when a flu patient, influenza patient comes to me, comes to us, what we do so that the symptom goes away. That is the only important part. I'll take another 5 minutes to complete it. And that we have been doing for last 10 years already, during my practice in Vietnam or India or Malaysia, wherever I have centers. So what we do, the moment any patient comes with a symptom, symptom is very important, feverish or body ache or cough and cold or all of them together, right? The moment they come with those symptoms, we offer them 3-step flu diet. And the moment they do it, for 95% of the patients, within 3 days, all the symptom vanishes and he's free from the symptom, means he's free from the illness, right? So we do not differentiate between COVID patient, dengue patients, H1N1 patients, influenza patients. For us, it is a flu, right? And nobody can distinguish. If two people comes, one is a COVID positive with a symptom, one COVID negative but with a symptom. By looking at the patient, can any doctor in the world differentiate that which one is COVID patient? Nobody can. Right, and the COVID patient, if you do test 10 times, again they will come out negative right here. Whereas all the symptoms are still there. So don't believe this, you have to upgrade your knowledge. Right, and now the last 5 minutes, that is what we do, we give them 3-step flu diet with the people who comes with the flu. Right, we call it flu, we call it influenza-like illness. So what is that 3-step flu diet? This is something which you should learn, because flu is something which happens to everybody in the world every year. Whatever is your age, my age is say 48, this means in my life, at least 45 times, I have also conquered the flu. That's why I'm alive, that's why you're alive. So how to conquer the flu? Anyway you rest, within few days, we recover. That's what we did in last several years. But if you want to cure it very fast, then you can take 3-step flu diet. The 3-step flu diet is very simple, and I will just show you through one poster, and so that you understand it and easily, and one poster. Thank you, sir. So now this is the poster. If you can make it closer, three step flu diet. What is this three step flu diet? The moment you have the first sign of flu means you are feeling feverish, even if it is not a fever. You start with the first day. Day one is body weight divided by 10. Let's say the patient's body weight is 60 kg divided by 10, that becomes 6. 6 glass of coconut water in the whole day and 6 glass of citrus fruit juice in the whole day. Right? This means 12 glass he has to consume, and 300 ml glass or 400 ml glass, big glass, and freshly squeezed juice and with lot of fiber. Nothing to eat, nothing to drink except these two. Water one can drink. This is what the first day. By first day, I have seen for most of the patient, within 24 hours, their fever at least come in control, 100 and 101, something like this. It do not give discomfort. The first step. Second day diet, it is called the fluid diet, solid and liquid in between. Your body weight divided by 20. Body weight is 60 by 20, that becomes 3. One more thing, body weight into 5. Body weight, let's say 60 kg man into 5, 300, make it gram. 300 gram cucumber and tomato, together 300 gram. This is the diet for day 2. By day 2 end, the person is comfortable for most of them. Temperature is not there. Day 3 morning, last day, that is weight by 30, body weight is 60 kg, divided by 30, that becomes 2. 2 glass coconut water and 2 glass citrus fruit juice by 12 noon. Lunch will be same as yesterday, 300 gram cucumber and tomato. By dinner, the person's symptom is gone. So dinner, he can have vegetarian cooked food, and fourth day, he can go for work. This is what we have been doing, and by doing so, we cured 50,000 patients in the month since COVID so-called pandemic was announced, and without a single death, and nobody has come to us again saying that kind of sickness has come. So this is what we have been doing for last several years, and this year also I did not do anything new. The same thing we followed, and this means there is nothing new. So my message is that if you want to how the COVID pandemic in 2020, COVID pandemic in 2021, what to do? Only one thing you do and the pandemic will end. Stop reading the newspaper and stop watching the mainstream media. The day you do that, COVID pandemic will vanish from your life. Thank you.
You all have heard two different approaches to deal with this COVID-19 in 2021. One is very clear and very specific and a quick way to get out of it. And I personally believe the citrus and coconut water. Actually, this citrus and coconut water treatment has been actually suggested by one great chemist by name Linus Pauling. He actually had two Nobel Prizes, one for chemical bonding and another for Nobel Peace Prize also. But then his work has been actually delegated to corners of history because it doesn't suit pharmaceutical companies' interests. As simple as that. Vitamin C, a lemonade. We have identified in the last 25 years there are three aspects for any person to be healthy and to be with strong immunity. Vitamin C, vitamin B, vitamin D. Very simple. These three major keystone aspects of human life is taken care of. There is no need for any panic or any fear for anyone on this planet. That is, if you maintain good microbial gut microbes, which will clear your vitamin B business. And everyone gets up in the morning and with all due respect, give two namaskaras to our sun, your vitamin D business is finished. And the only thing that is left, vitamin C, and that is all the khatta things, sour things, be it mango, be it lemon, be it tomato, be it gooseberry, be it avocado in Mexico. There are wonderful khatta things given by God in each and every nook and corner of this planet. And this aspect of vitamin C has been touched upon by many great scientists, but then these pharmaceutical companies and the so-called allopathic doctors, please, with all due respects to all the doctors in the world, we all have to identify and tell the patients, do these three things. And I challenge anyone on this planet, do these three things. There are no infections for you. No infections. And there will be viruses, there will be bacteria. We have been with them for time immemorial. There is nothing new, nothing bad, some mutations here and there. And, okay. All these things, we have been in trying to make pharmaceutical companies further themselves, creating all bogus information. I call it bogus information because what they are saying is not untrue, but they are using it for a particular agenda. That's what I call it's bogus information. There is corona, there is H1N1, there is H5N1, and there will be many more strains that will be developed because of our artificially making food. Many, many animals are produced artificially on this planet now, besides the natural ones. Like, there are now 10 billion pigs, which are actually artificially being produced on a daily basis, you know. Like, 3 months, they have to put on 300 kilos. In 6 months, 700 kilos. Bines, all these cows are being produced. And with what? With all the steroid injections and all artificial feeds, antibiotics. So what happens? There is immunity loss of these animals, and they create all kinds of viruses, but they cannot create a new thing. They can only mutate things. No one can create new things. It's all in nature. You only change a little bit here and there. And that's what is happening. So everywhere they say, oh, this is a new one. We have claimed. What new one? Dr. Bishwaroop clearly demonstrated very clearly that no one knows what is what. That simple demonstration, I really appreciate that. So you cannot figure out five. How can you figure out 50 million kinds of different varieties of strains and things like that? So our approach to this chasing vaccines, chasing viruses, is the most unscientific thing that you can think of. So instead of making yourself immune strong, you are going on creating one after the other vaccines. Now, as these people claim themselves, there are already now 100 strains. Even if you create one vaccine for 10 strains, you need 10 vaccines for this just simple corona. So no other work. As soon as the baby is born, one after the other vaccines you go on injecting. What kind of science we are talking about? What kind of nonsense we are talking about? So the best options you have is to make yourself immune strong. I'm not particularly worried about corona. There may be a virus which is more pathogenic to the human race coming in the future. So I don't care whether it is corona or corona number 2, corona 100. It doesn't matter. That's the most important thing. In fact, the coconut water that Bishwaroop has been using for the last 10 years is very good because of the fructose. It's not glucose-based. If you feed a sick fellow glucose, he will become more sick, wrong ones. And that is the advantage. You have coconut, toddy palm, fishtail palm, all these natural fructose-based plants give you the sweet, wonderful liquid. And that is why coconut water and lemon juice will cure any kind of these stupid things. So I'm glad there are certain simple things that can protect human race. 2021 COVID-19 or 2038 COVID-19, 2048 COVID-19, it hardly matters. You need only this much. And the medical fraternity has to simply leave their whatever you call greed or I don't know what it is. It is very simple. Let's not scare people. Let's not do this damage to the developing countries who are struggling to find their feet. And now you get this so-called pandemic. It looks like a pandemic. We need to come out of this hypocritic way of doing things. Let's be scientists. Let us speak the truth. Simple truth. There is no virus. We have been living with lots of viruses. And it is the loss of immunity that gives you in. They are not really dangerous. It is we who have become weak. That's all there is. Nothing more to it. And in the last 15 years or 20 years or so, we have actually had wonderful opportunities to find the nature's way of dealing with these kinds of issues. And we have figured out if your food is right, basically there is no need for any medicine. All this so-called, I'm going a little bit out of the caveat of this COVID-19 and 2021. But we don't need to actually worry about many diseases that the human race is struggling with, saying that they're all incurable. Like diabetes is incurable, BP is incurable, thyroid is incurable, autism, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, the list goes on and on and on. Actually, it's all our ignorance of what we are consuming. The food that we are consuming has become industrialized, and we are slowly losing the strength to hold and to fight and to protect ourselves from all these diseases. Be it chronic, be it infectious, it is the strength of your body, strength of your mind, strength of your immunity, strength of your bones, strength of your blood. All this, funnily, God has given us wonderful opportunity. It replenishes itself by itself. So if you are already sick, the next generation of the cells, new cells, can become healthy. And that is the principle we need to use, and that's where the right food comes into picture. So it doesn't matter whether you are cancerous, whether you are diabetic, whether you are thyroid patient, all these things can be eliminated in a matter of year or two if you follow the right food practices. And that is the basis on which we have worked in the last 15, 20 years. So use the natural biodiversity that is available in your local area and come up with beautiful decoctions, and we call it in our language kashaya. And it so happens kashaya also rhymes with kashaya, that is the ochre color of the sun god, which gives you vitamin D. So everything is in place and everything is very simple, straightforward. Why are we going around and round and round? As far as I am concerned, it is very simple, and if we can manage to communicate to all the human race on this planet, I believe in a matter of 5 to 10 years we can close down almost all the hospitals. Very simple. You may need few.
You are in sunshine.
It doesn't matter. How does it matter? Whether I am sunshine or... Sunshine is in real sunshine. The real sunshine is what I am asking for. Yeah. So, yeah, I am in sunshine. I am talking about sunshine. That's it. So, it doesn't matter where you are. And we all need, and we owe this to the human race in the coming future generations. We don't need to have hospitals. We need to have wellness centers. We need to create wellness, not deal with illness. So let's eliminate the illness and create wellness by simply following natural pathways, natural means of living. We have come away very far away. As Dr. G.B.K. Rao has so beautifully demonstrated and living the future. Actually, he is living the future. Here is a visionary who is living a future for the human race. And that's the kind of place that the human race has to build everywhere. You are living with the fauna and flora of your local areas. No, not even God can touch you. Not even God can give you the disease. Because you are with God. Nature is the God. So, being with God is what everyone should strive for. And that is natural way of living. So, respect nature. Each and every microbe, virus, bacteria, fungus, small plants, small animals, everything is sacred. We need to take care of them. Instead, we are killing everything that is around. And that's why we are in this trouble. That's why we are in this trouble. So do the least damage to the natural resources and continue to live on this planet. And that is the only way you can be healthy. There is no other means and methods. So conserving culture of our Sanatana Dharma has clearly laid the path. It's not that I am speaking in the last 15, 20 years I have found or discovered something. It is just following these great principles that our sadhus and rishis have taught so eloquently and so freely. Sadly, we are now trying to sell the intellectuality of humans. Buddhitananya ammukune buddhimandyam vachindi manava jatiki. In the name of Western thought process, intellectual property rights, patent culture. What nonsense? Isn't it nonsense? Is it yours? The thought itself is not yours. It's God's grace that you get thoughts. It's God's grace you sleep in the night. It's God's grace you wake up. It's God's grace you get sleep. So, let's remind ourselves every minute that the fact that you are breathing means you are blessed. So, let's not do unwanted things, unnatural things, and claim that you are doing something. Just let's follow the nature, follow the principles, be a student of nature. And I am actually glad to be associated or just to sit nearby such a great person. And it's not a small joke to create a place where you have all these wonderful plants and creepers, and it's just a pleasure to be in that place. Even if he doesn't invite me, I just go to his place. You don't need to eat anything. You just stay around, walk around. You see the smell, you see the flavor, you see the fragrance. Wonderful. That's what a forest can give you. And that's how we should live. Create all wonderful things around you, not these concrete jungles. The jungles and hospitals will not, these concrete jungles and hospitals will not give you health. They will only give you psychotic fear, nothing else. In fact, you ask anyone who walks into hospital, and when he is walking out, how are you? He says he's scared. That's the only word everyone walks out with. If it is something healing, then a patient should be willing to visit that place. This is the essence of creating wellness and managing the illness. So let's all work for wellness for the coming future generations. And it is as simple as knowing your food, knowing your environment, knowing your water, knowing the earth. So I just don't want to miss this opportunity to tell all the public that if you grow the food right, then you don't need hospitals. And that's why we need to encourage all the farmers that do not use chemicals to grow food. And that is the only path for future generations to live healthy. So let's abandon this industrial food culture propagated by these Western companies, and let's get back to our roots, literally to the roots. When we say roots, there is one simple plant called nanar, the root. We just go to Pragati, they will give you the decoction of that nanar. It will just remove all your restlessness in a matter of 5 minutes. That's all. However restless you are, you fought with your wife, you fought with your boss, whatever. Just drink this nanari decoction or sharbat. 5 minutes, I will challenge, I will bet. If you don't feel calmness, come back to me. Yeah, I don't want to. So there are like this wonderful natural things. So let's all in the future, the so-called doctors talk about these kinds of things rather than talking about vaccines, talking about MRI, talking about operations, talking about removing your gallbladder, removing this, removing that. Instead, restoring the damaged things naturally should be the path forward for the human race. Thank you all for giving me this opportunity.